I'm a type of person who's really addicted to details. Whenever I draw, I always want to make it as realistic as possible. Hey guys, I am John. I'm a first-year architecture student here in the Philippines. And for today's video, I'm going to show you how to make something like this. Many people have been requesting a tutorial video on how I render these architectural drawings, so now I'm going to talk about the step-by-step process on how to make these drawings. Before anything else, I am using Prismacolored pencils and Touch 5 markers, but any alternatives would work just fine. Let me show you a quick time-lapse on the process, and by the way, don't forget to subscribe. So the first thing that I always do is apply base colors with alcohol markers. I really recommend doing this because one, it's faster, and two, it will make your drawing smoother. This is the technique I use to avoid those colored pencil textures or the graphite textures that you usually get when using colored pencils. With a combination of alcohol markers and colored pencils, especially when you use them with the same shades, it will really make blending a lot easier. The reason why we get those graphite textures because we applied it on a white paper. So the white spots are very visible. But when you use colored pencils on a colored paper, those white spots would not be visible. So your drawing will be a lot smoother and cleaner. The second step is apply initial shadows to your drawing. You can use a little darker color of alcohol markers, or you can just add a second layer with the same color. This step is actually optional, but I do this because it shows the basic form of the drawing. This helps me visualize the entire drawing, and the process of applying shadows and details would be a lot easier. Once again, this is just optional and you can just proceed to adding shadows right away. The third step is to add shadows. When applying shadows, I usually add three layers of shadows: light, dark, and a darker shadow. But don't use the black color unless the shadow is really black in your reference. Make sure your shadows are just darker color of your base color. I really recommend having at least two layers when adding shadows because it really adds depth to your drawing. If you look closely, shadows are not just one dark spot. It is a series of dark tones that fade from dark to light. So having three layers of shadows really helps you achieve that smooth fade and will make your drawing more realistic. The fourth step is applying textures. This step is the part where I take most of my time because it's really time consuming. But when it's all finished, I promise you it will be all worth it. One of the reasons why my drawings look realistic because I really take time on adding textures on every single object on my drawing. When you have a reference, sometimes textures are not visible. That is why most people forget this step because they're just merely copying their reference. But what I do is I apply my own textures that I think is appropriate to the object. For instance, the grass on this drawing are not actually visible in my reference because it's a wide shot. But I still add grass textures just to make the drawing more polished and realistic, because it will just look too flat without it. If you're rendering a rock, put imperfections on it. If it's sand, put dots on it to emphasize that it is really sand. So the next step that I will be sharing to you is the best one and can really make your drawing a lot better. Many people have been saying that my drawings look like printed and have been asking how I did it. The only thing that I did to achieve that is to use the black colored pencil. I used the black colored pencil to add ambient occlusion to my drawing. Ambient occlusion is basically a shading and a rendering technique that makes ambient lighting more realistic. This is maybe the first time you heard this, because this term is usually used in 3D computer graphics, but don't stress out. I learned this technique when I was studying digital art and I was thinking how I could apply it in traditional art. In simpler words, ambient occlusion is basically the shadow in between objects. When two objects are placed near with each other, lighted with a light source, ambient occlusion is basically the shadow in between them. And it is usually the darkest shadow in the scene. It is because the space between those objects, especially when they are closer, no light is coming in. Let me just show you how ambient occlusion works. So with the use of the black colored pencil, you can apply it to the darkest part of the scene. But don't overuse it, because you can ruin your work when you messed up. You can just look at your reference and apply it to the darkest part of the scene, but exaggerating the shadows just a little bit in between objects really makes your drawing better. Applying ambient occlusion really makes your drawing pop, because it really adds contrast to your drawings and it separates the objects from each other. So the last step that you need to do when you already finished all the steps that I mentioned is to add highlights. I'm using a gel pen to add my highlights, and I bought it from Lazada. It has no brand, but it works excellent. The only thing that I want you not to do is don't put highlights on everything, because that's mostly what beginners always do. When you want to add highlights on some parts of the scene, just use the white colored pencil instead to lighten the color. So that's it, guys. That is how I render my architectural drawings. I hope you learned something from this video, and I just want to take this opportunity to thank you all, guys, for all of your support. We already hit 300 subs and our first 1,000 views on YouTube in just 2 weeks, and I hope you'll keep on supporting me. I promise to do everything in my power to share what I know and hopefully give good content. And if this video is still not enough, leave your questions in the comment section below, or you can just message me on Instagram and I'll respond to it as soon as possible. So we'll just end the video here. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. I will be making more artsy and architecture related content soon. This is John once again, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye.